Hey, look! There are some eyes shining. It's a flying squirrel. And there it goes. I am Akhi. I live in a village in Arunachal Pradesh, close to a big wildlife sanctuary the government made many years ago. We hunt and fish in these forests. I used to be an expert hunter. The animals were disappearing because of too much hunting. A while ago, we decided to stop. Now, slowly, the animals are coming back. Let's take a walk through these forests that I know so well. It rains a lot in Arunachal, and the plants love it. We use many of them for food and medicine. There are also colorful flowers. The big trees need a lot of light to grow tall. No light reaches the forest floor, so all of them fight to reach for the sky. There are many streams that crisscross our forests. They flow into big rivers, and we build bridges of cane and bamboo to cross these rivers. That's the great hornbill, the biggest of all hornbills. They've been hunted for many years now and are now very scared of people. I feel bad that I have killed quite a few. Some tribes in Arunachal Pradesh hunt them for their huge beaks and casque. They have a tradition of wearing them. People say they have vanished from many places in Arunachal. But in these forests, they are still plenty, especially since we stopped hunting. These are the wreathed hornbills, which move in big flocks searching for ripe fruit. I think the rufous-necked hornbill is the most beautiful. It is rare and seen only in the higher hills. Hornbills nest in tree holes. The male brings fruit to feed the female and chicks inside, day after day, even in bad weather. Many tribes believe that it is a sin to kill males at this time because the female and the chicks will die inside the tree hole with no food. The rainforests depend on hornbills for their survival. Hornbills eat fruit of many trees and deposit the seeds far and wide. These seeds grow into big trees. There are also many smaller birds. The flycatchers. The sibiers. The barbets. Euhenas. Male birds are colorful to show off to the females, just like the men in our village do. We are near a big river now, where the birds are different. Some birds stay in the water, others live near the water's edge. This bird is the forktail. They wag their tails all the time. We see them near small streams. This bird is a merganser. It's a duck that only comes here in the winter. And between these rocks is the ibis bill, a rare bird. There is one special animal which also stays in the water. The otter. It catches fish and crab by diving in the river. Look, there's a sambar in the water. Oh, that's a wild dog jumping in the water. Another one is on the banks. And the hunt is on. They've got it. Oh, they've missed. They've they missed this time too. The dogs finally have it. Look, both of them are pulling it onto the bank. That's the end of the sambar. Let's leave these wild dogs to feed in peace and move on. Look at this bamboo. Inside it lives a creature that we are scared of. It's a green snake called the meadow's pit viper, and it has a poisonous bite. It hunts by lying silently, waiting for its prey. When its prey is close, it lunges forward to strike. There are other snakes we find in our forest. The thin green vine snake that looks like a creeper. The rare king cobra, which is the largest poisonous snake I have seen. Can you hear that call? That's what we wake up to every morning. It's the hoolock gibbon. The forest comes alive with their calls. They are full of joy. They use their long arms to swing from tree to tree. I see something moving on the next tree. That's the capped langur. Some tribes use their fur to cover their dhows. There are other monkeys too, like the Assamese macaque, pig-tailed macaque, stump-tailed macaque, and the rhesus macaque. Hey, up on that tree is a Malayan giant squirrel. This one is the biggest of all squirrels. There are several smaller ones in these forests, like the red-bellied squirrel and the hoary-bellied squirrel. The smallest of all is the Himalayan striped squirrel. It moves very fast. I see them usually on tree trunks, stripping their bark to chew on. I head towards a swampy forest pool. I approach silently, hoping to find some animals. As I catch my first glimpse of the pool, I spot a pair of white-winged wood ducks. Arre, I have just disturbed the gaur that was coming to drink at the pool. These are the hoof marks of the barking deer and the tracks of a small cat. Many animals in this forest come out only in the night. The animals are shy. I worked for a while with a wildlife researcher. We used special cameras which we can leave behind and the animals can take their own pictures. We set them up along paths which are used by the animals. Just for fun, we also clicked some of ourselves. We go home and come back several days later to check on them. Initially, we didn't have much success. But soon, our luck changed. The peacock pheasants. And once, a whole bunch of college pheasants. We got lots of barking deer. A few sambar deer. And wild pigs. That's the biggest I have seen. A brush-tailed porcupine. The Malayan sun bear. They have a good sense of smell. Looks like this one came to smell our camera. Then, we got a whole host of small carnivores. Crab-eating mongoose. Large Indian civet. Hog badger. At one place near a waterhole, even an elephant came. It smelt the camera and ran with its tail up in the air. And then we got the cats. What was that? The golden cat. The smallest of the cats, the leopard cat. They come into my village to kill chickens. And the beautiful clouded leopard. It hunts monkeys. We call it Shemizala, the one who eats Assamese macaques. This one is the marbled cat. and we got a wild dog followed by its pups. And then came the king of the jungle, the tiger. We are lucky to have got this one. Very few are left in our forests. Hey, that nervous elephant has come back again. She's sniffing our camera. Hurry, she has ripped the camera and she's carrying it away. So now we know who the thief was. I hope you enjoyed this walk. I am now 55. I have roamed these forests since I was a child. There used to be a lot more wildlife then. I don't want these forests to become empty and silent. I hope we can continue to hear the hoolock singing and the forests alive with all its other creatures. I hope all of you will help them remain for future generations to see. Thank you.